This is Kurt Heisinger, accounting professor at Sierra College and author of Managerial Accounting. This video describes how to calculate the direct labor variances that are related to manufacturing companies. We'll start by talking about standard costs. Standard costs, in the first bullet point here, are used to establish the flexible budget for direct labor. We talk about that in a separate video, how to calculate the flexible budget, how to create standard costs and how to calculate the flexible budget. So I'll review it again here. The flexible budget is the standard cost per unit times the actual number of units produced. So again, it's not the same as the master budget. The master budget is the standard cost per unit times the estimated or budgeted units to be produced. The flexible budget is prepared after the fact, looking back in time, knowing that we produced a certain number of units, we are figuring out what we would have expected then the costs to be, knowing that we calculated a certain number of units. The flexible budget then is compared to actual costs, and the difference is shown in the form of two variances, and you'll see that at the bottom here. We have the labor rate variance and the labor efficiency variance. So we're going to break out the difference from the flexible budget to our actual costs related to direct labor, and we'll look at them by way of two different variances, the labor rate variance and the labor efficiency variance. Let's start by looking at the labor rate variance. The labor rate variance, and we'll look at what it is and then how we calculate it. The labor rate variance focuses on the wages paid for labor. And it answers this important question right here, and that is, did we spend as a company, as a manufacturing company, did we spend more or less on direct labor than we expected to spend? And then at the very bottom here, you'll see how we calculate the labor rate variance. And you can look at the details in the bullet point right above this formula. But the labor rate variance is calculated by taking the actual hours that our direct labor workforce worked times the actual rate per hour. And then we'll subtract from that, so that's our actual cost, and we'll subtract from that the actual hours worked by our workforce, direct labor workforce, multiplied by the standard rate per hour. That is the rate we expected to pay our employees. And so that's how we find the labor rate variance. How much did we actually pay our direct labor workforce, and what did we expect to pay them based on the actual hours that they worked? Next, we'll take a look at the labor efficiency variance and talk about what this represents and how we calculate it. The labor efficiency variance focuses on the number of labor hours used in production. So it answers this question right here. Did we use more or less direct labor hours in production than we expected to use? And we calculate that using this formula right here at the very bottom. And again, the details are right up above this formula. The labor efficiency variance is calculated by taking the actual hours worked by our direct labor workforce and multiplying that by the standard rate per hour. That is what we expected to pay them on an hourly basis. And we subtract from that the standard hours that we expected our direct labor workforce to work given actual production. There'll be more details on that calculation a little bit later. And we multiply that times the standard rate per hour. So we hold the standard rate per hour constant here, and we're really comparing the standard hours to the actual hours. And again, we'll get into a detailed calculation here shortly. So here's an example of some detailed calculations that are needed to come up with the labor rate variance and labor efficiency variance. So I'll take it from a broad view to start, and then we'll look at the details. What you'll see here is the labor rate variance in this box on the left, and then the labor efficiency variance in this box on the right. And you'll notice, as we mentioned before, that we're focusing on the labor rate variance. You'll notice that we calculate that by taking the difference between actual hours times the actual rate per hour and the actual hour times the standard rate per hour. So that this 37,800 unfavorable variance is the difference between those two. And now we'll dive in a little deeper and look at the calculations, and then I'll move over to the right to talk more about the labor efficiency variance in a minute. Looking upper left here at the actual labor cost, we know that our actual labor costs from our payroll records related to direct labor totaled $283,500. And the number of hours, that actual number of hours that our direct labor workforce worked totaled 18,900. Oftentimes, we have to back in then to the $15 per hour actual rate. That's the average actual rate that we paid our direct labor workforce. And we do that by simply taking the $283,500 and dividing it by the 18,900 hours. And that gives us this $15 per hour. Then we compare that total to the calculation to the right here, which is the actual number of hours, the 18,900, times the standard rate we expected to pay our employees, which is $13 per hour. And you're going to see right away here, we expected to pay our employees $13 per hour. We actually paid our employees $15 per hour, so we have an unfavorable variance. We paid our employees more than we expected to pay. So let's finish this out. The $13 per hour times 18,900 hours is $245,700. Let's compare that then to this $283,500, and you'll see we have a $37,800 unfavorable variance, unfavorable labor rate variance. Now let's move to the right. And before I go too far with this, you can look at the very bottom at the footnotes to get the details if you want to pause this and take a look at the details of where these numbers come from. So now we're going to move to the right, and you'll see that we're going to compare the flexible budget with the middle column. So this is our flexible budget here, and we calculate it by taking the standard number of hours given actual production. So go down to the footnote, and you'll see down here, right here, this footnote here, that this is the calculation that sometimes causes problems with students, so that's why I want to focus on it a little bit. The standard hours of 21,000 equals is the standard number of hours given actual units produced and sold. And we have a standard 0.1 hours per unit, that's what's needed per unit, and we produced 210,000 units, so the standard number of hours is 0.1 times 210,000, or 21,000. And that's what you see right here, upper right. And then we multiply that times the standard rate of $13 per hour, and that gives us $273,000. We take the difference between that and the $245,700, and that gives us a favorable labor efficiency variance of $27,300. And it should be favorable because we expected to work our direct labor workforce to work 21,000 hours, and they actually worked 18,900 hours. They worked less than we expected, therefore we have a favorable labor efficiency variance. And so what we've done here is, going from left to right, we've compared the actual direct labor costs with our flexible budget, and the difference is denoted in these two white boxes, these two variances. We had an unfavorable rate variance. We paid more than we expected by $2 an hour, totaling $37,800. And we have a favorable labor efficiency variance of $27,300 because our employees work fewer hours than we expected them to work. This slide outlines some of the possible explanations or possible causes for the variances that you saw on the previous slide related to our direct labor costs. And so I'll go through a couple of these. The unfavorable labor rate variance that you saw on the previous slide could be caused by a number of different issues, and we would normally in a company setting go out and find out. We talk to our production personnel and see why we had an unfavorable labor rate variance, and our HR department, our human resource department, might be able to help us with this as well. So one example is that we had potentially had a higher mix of skilled workers, and as a result, and that could be a good thing for us, but as a result, the rate that we had to pay those employees was higher than we expected or than we anticipated before the year started. So that's one possible reason that we had the unfavorable labor rate variance. You can take a look at some of these other ones on your own as well. There can be many possible reasons why we have the variance. And then going to the right, we had, if you recall from the previous slide, a favorable labor efficiency variance. Our employees were efficient. And so what might cause that? Well, actually, first bullet point here, it could be for the same reason, that we had a higher mix of skilled workers, and maybe it cost us more, as you saw with the unfavorable labor rate variance, but they were more efficient in the use of labor hours, and that created then a favorable labor efficiency variance. And you can take a look at some of these other possible causes as well for the favorable labor efficiency variance, and again, realize we would normally go out and talk to the folks in our organization to find out why we had these variances, and then usually we'll do planning going forward using this information, and hopefully that will help our company to be more efficient as we move forward.